lateral direction. So from here we can understand that the water and minerals as well as the food which is manufactured by the plant is all conducted to all different parts by the help of the vascular tissue known as xylem and phloem. Xylem and phloem, they are the complex tissue because they are made up of different type of cells and they help in the conduction of water from root to the shoot as well as conduction of food from leaves to all other parts of the plant. Xylem actually forms a continuous network of channels that connect root to the leaves through the stem and branches and thus transport water to the entire plant. And we know very well that leaves synthesize the food and the food, it has to be transported to all the parts of plant. And this process is done by another vascular tissue called the phloem. So xylem and phloem, they both help in the conduction of or transport of substances in the plant. Because plants, they cannot move from here and there. So they are having special tissues for the performance of the different work. And plants have, you can say, pipe-like vessels, which is a part of a xylem tissue. These pipe-like vessels, it help in transport of water and nutrients from the soil. And these vessels, they are made up of special cells and they form the vascular tissue. So this is the transport of, this is how the transport of substances in plants takes place. So xylem tissue, it helps in the conduction of water and mineral. It goes to the leaf and leaf from the stomata, it absorbs the carbon dioxide, manufacture the food by the process of photosynthesis in the chloroplast tissue, and that is transported to all other parts of the plant when the food gets manufactured. Some is utilized by the leaf cells and rest is sent to the portions where it is accumulated and transported to the growing portions in the plant. So okay students, that's all for our lesson number 11. We have discussed all our topics through this. In this one activity is also given, that is 11.3 activity on page number